Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. This is part two of our July garden tour. Come on and see what's growing in the rest of the garden. We have a tiny little baby hydrangea that we planted last year right here. And obviously it's too little to have flowers, but eventually it will. And then this is another mock orange that gets a little more sunlight, so it seems to be a little taller than the one over there, but still wonderful smelling.
And also very fragrant.
Very, very nice. This is a Bosnian pine, very slow growing, which is perfect for this setting. We don't want it to get huge fast. And in there we have another plant that is a goldenrod, again a dwarf goldenrod that's supposed to stay nice and not get crazed. I see one of these little guys moved itself from way over there.
Oh yeah.
This is I'm not sure what the name of this is. It looks like a pricker, but it's
a thistle.
It looks like a thistle. It's probably in the thistle family, but it's a cultivar that in the spring. This is a little row of fantastic tulips. They're just gorgeous. Now, of course, the tulips are gone, so you need something that'll take over where the tulips were. This is called sea holly. This is a plant that will grow in a space where there is not much water. It is a little prickly on the leaves, but not awful. It does attract a lot of bees, though, so if you are not liking too many bees. And the dill has now taken over. That's fine because every time I come out here, I can smell like pickles are growing in my yard. And the liatris. Again, I love liatris. It's everywhere. Now this is a baby from a relative of the sea holly, I'm thinking. This is a white version. And that obviously seems to like to seed itself other places.
This is almost 5 foot tall.
Yes, it will get that tall, and it will have white flowers on it. These would be great for drying, for dried flower arrangements.
And I love your bush. Well, of course, you have all the different irises that are in here.
The irises are still here. They're still regaining their strength, so I'll just leave them. This is a Baptista.
That's at least 3 foot tall.
Right, these were flower stems on here. Beautiful bush. It has beautiful purple flowers in the spring. And then this spring, we were able to pick up a yellow one. So hopefully that'll be as luscious as this.
Did you plant a yellow one?
I did.
Where?
I'll show you.
Oh, okay.
Strawberries, if you want to take a look at the strawberries. Middle one did very well, and we have picked and eaten several quarts of those. That side is doing well over there. Ooh, there's a monarch.
Yeah.
Welcome.
We've lost, I'd say, at least two-thirds of our strawberries, at least.
But I think they were overcrowded, for one thing, and then we had droughts and we had winters that weren't good. This bed is now coming back. There are so many shoots coming out, so I have a feeling that next year will be a good year for them.
Well, then, plus you had an amazing hedge of beautiful peonies.
Oh, the peonies.
I mean, they were just absolutely gorgeous. I think I'll superimpose some pictures of them over this video so people can appreciate how beautiful they really were.
I'm watching the monarch butterfly. I'm hoping he's going to find the milkweed over there.
I'm sure he or she will.
Yeah, and you can see that this is the south side. So this is the side in the winter that takes a beating. The north side is fine.
Yeah.
Which is, which makes it even harder. This is a buckthorn. And yes,
Don't shudder. Be patient. Listen.
But this is a non-spreading buckthorn. It doesn't send out runners. It doesn't have seeds that sprout. So we love the texture of it. And it doesn't get real large.
Yeah.
Peony that still needs to be headed.
Yeah.
And this is rose mallow. that I planted a couple years back. I planted seeds in the back and I loved it. It came up the next year from seed, and so I moved them around so we could have a variety. Stelladora daisies, Stelladora lilies, excuse me. More rose mallow, tiger lilies, more rose mallow. There's a theme here.
Well, it's nice to have the color hopping here.
There's some
Fleece plant.
That I tried taking it out of there this spring because I knew there was going to be other things. Uh-huh. So that one's come up. Anybody wants some, come and get some. Tiger lilies. And then this is another peach. It's acting as a trellis for the... Doing very nicely. Hopefully next year we'll have some blossoms and some fruit. Quince. We planted this a couple years ago. We didn't know what it was, but now we know. But isn't that a unique growing
flower
system? I mean, it's regular leaves and then these tiny little leaves. And it does have little spikes on it. This one year when we had a very strange fall, and it was warm all the way into December, there was one little fruit on it. And we, at the time, didn't know what it was. But we've not seen fruit since, so.
Well, we've also been trimming it, though, too, to keep it under control.
It gets beautiful scarlet flowers on it in the spring.
Yes.
So it's lovely. Sedum. And all of this orange that you see, this is all called tickweed, which again, I planted from seeds, and I wasn't happy with it because it spread too much, but Rick loves it. He loves the orange and the way it
takes over. I like the color. It's, you know, it's a nice contrast to all the green in here.
Now see, what is that? I have no idea. Help me out, somebody.
Yeah, pretty whatever it is.
Has a four-leaf,
four-petal?
A four-petal white flower with kind of a yellow plume in the center. Very tiny, but perhaps that's just a baby of something.
Right.
And then all your grasses that you have.
The grasses are against excellent, the thing. Aren't they?
In fact, we picked up some new grasses that we put in the very front, which we'll go to next.
The blue heaven.
Yeah.
Yep.
So again, this is an area that we really haven't spent a whole lot of time on since we got rid of the wood fence about 2 years ago, was it? 3 years ago?
Yeah, at least. But you can see that the lungwort has taken over. So lungwort, lovely as it is, it will move. The nice thing about lungwort is that it has a shallow root. So when it gets to a place where you don't want it, you can just easily nudge it out. And this is almost always in shade, which is obvious because of the ferns.
Well, you have this huge maple tree here.
Yes,
that's...
it's really happy that we took down the ash trees that used to stun
now,
it.
Now, is this a maple tree that I dragged over here and planted?
No, I think these two maples were here, but
we're
they were
here?
Stunted by the ash trees and silver maple.
Yeah.
All these ferns that you see are from our son Keys and Tanya's backyard. They needed the backyard to grow their garden, and we got their ferns. Thanks, guys. And as we were walking the other day, look what I found. This is our one and only apple this year. It's a Macintosh.
Oh, we just planted these, what, last year?
Oh, 2 years ago.
2 years ago?
Mm-hmm. And we had to protect them because of the rabbits and the deer, which we did, and it obviously is making a difference.
Now we put another one on this side too, but I don't see any apples on this one
yet. Not
yet, so.
No. Next year.
Well, let's go look at the grapes.
All right. Thanks for watching this part of our July garden tour. If you have questions or comments, we'd love to hear them. If you enjoyed it, please give us a thumbs up. And as always, we'd love to have you join our garden family and subscribe. There's more to come. Please watch another one.
Connect with us on YouTube.